In last tutorials, we will learn how to connect to Photon servers, create room and join room. And in this tutorial, we will learn how to create, move and show player to another users in real time after joining a room. This is a default player, which is supposed to be the player of whoever joins the game. Now to produce this player, add a script called Photon View for it. Create a new folder in Assets, name it Resources. Move any file you want to produce online here and prefab it. So drag player in Resources folder and delete it from scene. Now create a game object called Spawner. The job of a spawner is to instantiate a player for everyone who joins the game. In a script, use photon.pon up here. Then for produce, write in a start photonnetwork.instantiate. In first part, write producing object name, I mean player. And in second part, write producing position of player, which I think negative 8 and positive 8 is good for X, and for Y, I think negative 1.5 is good. So in a script, use random range for these two. Next part is angle, which it isn't important for me, so I write quaternion.identity. Let's test. In loading page, press play, create a room, then from pre-built game, join this room. Look, we have two players in any of our games. Let's check their movement. Now create a new script called player and add a joystick to game, which is tutorial is in the channel. In player script, define a public joystick and define rigid body 2D called RV. Cause we wanna move player with rigid body, we should use fixed update. This command is for determining the value of the joystick. Next order is for moving player, and this order is for specifying player direction and playing animations. Drag the script to player. We have two sections here. First is joystick and second one is rigid body. Now we should give joystick to player. Cause player is not in the scene, we should do it from the script. So in a spawner, where we produce player, define a new joystick and equal player joystick with a spawner joystick. Now give joystick to a spawner. Again select player, add a rigid body for it and make gravity 0. Then give rigid body to RV. Let's test again, create a room and join it with pre-built game. Now we can move player, but there is an error. The reason of this error is because of one of players has no joysticks, and if you drag joystick towards it manually, all players move together. To fix it, in player script, use photon.pon up here, then in where player moves, I mean fixed update, write this if. If photon view is mine was equal to true, it means if player was mine, then run movement commands. So bring movement commands in this if. Now we have a problem. If anyone moves its player, this movement doesn't display to another users. For this, again select player. Add photon transform view classic script to it. Cause player moves, check position box, and cause it is going to rotate, check rotation box too. I set rotation on disabled cause I want rotate happen suddenly. Now if you want player's animation shows to another users, add photon animator view script to player. In parameters, mood is written. Mood is name of integer which I use it to manage animations. It's on disabled, which should be on discrete. Let's test. Create a room and join it again. Look, I move player, its movement displays to another players. But player's movement has some lags. This happens because of two reasons. First reason is because of my internet speed, which is terrible. And second reason is because of some photon settings. If you want to solve the lag problem, you can do it by three ways. 1. Photon lag simulation component. 2. Unserialized view void, which is very important. And 3. Send rate and serialization rate code. We will publish a tutorial about this topic for sure. Now let's specify which player is our player. Right click on player, make an image. Then change its size and other stuff as you want and name it Mark. In player script, define a game object called Mark. Then drag Mark to define a game object. deactivate mark, and click on player. From this section, press apply to save chains and delete player. Now in a spawner, where player gets produced, active mark. Let's test for last time. Create a room and join it by another game, and you will see my character is detectable with its mark. I hope you love this tutorial. Don't miss next episodes. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe us. Thank you.